Namaste. Hamesha Khush Rao Vithya. I am Jeevan Dr. Lily Trivedi, and today I am going to give a lecture to you on the subject of secondary growth in root and stems and type of wood. Now, this lecture is for BSc BEd 4th SEM ZBC. And the course is Anatomy, Ecology, and Evolution. And the session is Secondary Growth in Root and Stem and Types of Wood. Now, here is a diagram showing you the secondary growth in a root. Now, secondary growth is seen in roots in gymnosperm and diaphorm, but in monopods, it is absent except in Dracaena. Now, there are two parts, the fascicular cambium and the phellogen or pod. Now, here you can see four diagrams. Now, this is showing the normal layers of a normal root, which is epidermis, endodermis, pericycle, primary phloem, cambium, and primary xylem. There is a crescent-shaped cambium. Now, this crescent-shaped cambium is from the parenchyma cells, which are present below the primary phloem. We also have a centrifugal secondary xylem and the centrifugal secondary phloem. Centripetal secondary xylem and the centrifugal secondary phloem. So, therefore, they are formed in between the primary xylem bundles. Here you can see. Now, what happens over here? Here you can see that the cells against the protoxylem also become meristematic. That is, small strips of cambium against the protoxylem, and the cambium joins to form a wavy-like structure. So here you can see it's a wavy-like structure. Some meristematic cells here and the cambium here. So they all grow to form a wavy-like meristematic structure, the wavy ring of cambium. The development of the secondary tissues are there inside the phloem first and then outside the primary xylem. So here you will see it is first inside the primary phloem and then outside the primary xylem. Therefore, the secondary xylem opposite to phloem pushes the cambium, and thus a wavy outline is formed. Now here we see further growth takes place, and the secondary phloem and the secondary forms a ring-like structure. Now as we see, the different rings are formed, and here you can see now we have a different structure. What is here? We have the outside. This is the secondary xylem is formed. The primary xylem is present on the inside. The secondary phloem is present, and the primary xylem is crushed here. Then outer we have the endodermis, cortex, and epidermis. Now, as we go further, we will see this is the final stage of secondary growth in typical dicot root. Now, outer we have the epidermis or the cork, and then we have the phellogen or cork cambium. Then we have the primary phloem, which is crushed here in between, and the below that we have the secondary phloem, which is in form of a ring. Here you can see the phloem rays are present. They are cells opposite developing. And then we have the cambium ring, which was developed. Then we have the secondary xylem and the primary xylem. So we see the xylem rays and the phloem rays. The rays are cells opposite to primary xylem developing medullary rays. So this is how we have the secondary growth in a typical dicot root. Now in woody roots, what happens? There is enormous amount of secondary tissue, and the phellogen or the cork cambium gives rise to phellum or cork on the outer side, and phellodum or cork, secondary cortex on the inner side. The phellum is protective in there, and the periderm is storage for the roots. And such roots we are seeing in the compositae family, Chenopodiaceae family, etc. Now, we have different kinds of secondary growth in roots, which that we are going to discuss in another topic, anomalous secondary growth. Now let's come to the secondary growth of dicot stem. These are the various stages which we see in a dicot stem during secondary growth. A portion of the procambium, that is between xylem and phloem, forms the fascicular cambium. Here you can see this is the fascicular cambium, and in between the two fascicular cambium develops the interfascicular cambium, and which becomes meristematic, and thus it becomes a full ring of cambium. Now here you can see the primary phloem and the primary xylem. Now the whole ring is formed, and therefore the inter and the intra, both cambium together, form the fascicular cambium. Now this fascicular cambium will give rise to secondary xylem and secondary phloem, and the fusiform cells give rise to secondary xylem and secondary phloem, and the ray cells which give rise to secondary medullary rays. So here you can see the vascular rays and the secondary phloem and the secondary xylem. On the outside is the phloem and inside is the xylem. Thus, there is a complete circumference or cylinder of secondary vascular tissues around. So this is the final, what we see here. We have the cork as the outside. These are lenticels in the stem. They are breathing organs. And after this lenticels, we have the cork, then the secondary cortex. And after this, we have the secondary phloem, the secondary xylem, and in between is the interfascicular cambium. Then as the secondary growth takes place year after year, we have the annual ring. So this is the first annual ring, and what is formed later is the second annual ring. Now let's move further. This is the comparison between the secondary growth in a dicot stem and the secondary growth in a dicot root. Now you see over here the secondary growth in a dicot stem. The cambium ring is formed circular in a cross section from the beginning. In dicot root, it is wavy and later becomes circular. In dicot stem, there is fascicular cambium and interfascicular cambium. In dicot root, the cambium is completely secondary in origin. That means it was partially primary in a dicot stem already present, and partially it was secondary. In a dicot stem, the periderm originates from the cortical cell, that is extracellular in origin. Whereas in dicot root, the periderm originates from the pericycle, that is intracellular. More cortex cork is produced in the stem, which is above ground, and less amount of cork is produced in the root, which is underground. Lenticels are more prominent in the dicot stem, and in dicot root they are not prominent. So this is a flow chart which is showing the basic of, this is a dicot stem and dicot root. So here we have in a dicot stem, the procambium which gave rise to fascicular cambium and the medullary rays which gave rise to interfascicular cambium. Both are together forming vesicular cambium. The fusiform initials form the axial phloem, that is the secondary phloem and the secondary xylem. The ray initial forms the phloem rays and the xylem rays. The epidermis, cork and phloem, they are forming the cork cambium, that is phellogen, which gives rise to phellum, phelloderm and lenticels. In a dicot root, there is a conjunctive tissue which forms the vascular cambium and which has uniform initials and ray initials, which have similar to dicot stem. But the pericycle here is the origin for cork cambium and which gives rise to phellum and phelloderm, and lenticels are not much present. So that was about the secondary growth. Now let's come to the types of wood. Now we have growth ring. With woody plants of temperate region, they are having marked variation in the activity of different seasons. So there is a growing day and a quiescent or quiet period. As a consequence, we have the concentric rings are formed, which are growth or annual rings. Now we can calculate the age of a plant through these rings. One ring represents one season. Now we have two types of wood in it, the spring wood and the autumn wood. The spring wood has wide vessels, thin walls and more vegetative growth. Why? Because there is more transpiration during this time, there is more transport of water and the vessels are broad. Now in the autumn region, what happens? The variation of thickness is, there is less. So we have the autumn wood is of a different type. Now we also have heartwood and sapwood. Now what is heartwood and sapwood? The heartwood here is light colored and the sapwood is light colored and the heartwood is dark colored. Why is it dark? Because of presence of gums, resins and tannins. Now the sapwood is the outer wood of an old stem and heartwood is the inner wood of the old stem. So here again you see in the diagram, this is the heartwood and this is the sapwood. The sapwood is lighter in color, heartwood is darker in color. The sapwood is also called as alburnum and the dark wood is called as duramen. The sapwood is not soft, it is soft and not durable. The heartwood is hard and durable. Living cells are absent in heartwood and sapwood contains living cells. So since it is soft, it is lighter in weight and less durable because it is susceptible to attack of pathogens. But the heartwood is hard and durable, heavier in weight and more resistant to attack of pathogens. So as such, heartwood is more commercially valuable. The vessels are blocked by tylosis with various deposits and this is the function of this region is mechanical support. Whereas the sapwood function of this region is conduction of water and nutrients and storage of wood. Now we also have certain different porous and non-porous wood. Now as we discuss what is porous and non-porous wood. Now what is porous wood? The vessels are present in xylem. So that is porous wood. Since in gymnosperm no vessels are present, it is non-porous wood. The porous wood is hardwood and the non-porous wood is softwood. Now this is not on the basis of pliability of wood, but it is on the basis of, like we have the Bombax sebum, it is very soft. And Pinus and Cedrus is hardwood. So all this wood is not on the basis of the pliability. Then we have as if the ring porous and the diffuse porous. Now the pores are arranged in the two forms, the ring porous and the diffuse porous. In the ring porous, they are arranged in a ring or belt at the beginning of the growth ring. But in diffuse porous, there is no arrangement and the growth ring. Now we also have wood parenchyma. Now that is in the phloem. It has two types, axial and ray. The axial are long, fusiform cells, and rays are short, ray initial. So this was about types of wood and secondary growth in monocot, in dicot stem and dicot root. Now I've taken reference diagrams from these two references. I hope you found my lecture interesting, and if you have any query, any doubt, please write in the comment box. It will be resolved soon. This session, the digital session 2.0 of Jyoti Vidya Peeth. So I thank you very much. Namaste. Thank you.